हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज प्रोफेसर तुषार उगले वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड टेक्नोलॉजी के बाग कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर बायोटेक्नोलॉजी नासिक। टुडे वी विल गो थ्रू दी आवर सेकंड प्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ मेटामॉर्फोसिस, दैट इज द टाइप्स ऑफ इंसेक्ट एग्स, लार्वी एंड प्यूपा। सो इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव सीन दी डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ मेटामॉर्फोसिस एंड इट्स सिग्निफिकेंस इन इंसेक्ट लाइफ साइकिल। सो टुडे वी विल सी द इंसेक्ट एग एंड द type of pupa and the larval type, their modifications, their adaptation. The structure of typical insect egg having the different subparts like corian is the eggshell. It is secreted by the cell of the follicular epithelium of the ovary and is composed of lipoproteins arranged in a number of layers and is devoid of the chitin. Chitin is absent. It is formed by two layers, that is exocorian, that is the outer structure, the endocorian is the inner structure. In some of the insects, there is a wax layer coated on the exocorian as the outermost layer. Micropyle is the one hour small opening through the corian, usually at one end of the egg. Spermatozoa enter through the micropyle to fertilize the ovum. Beside this opening serves as a respiratory channel. So micropyle is a very important opening that is serves as a respiratory channel to the embryo. Vital membrane, that is the cell wall, the delicate membrane completely lining with the egg shell from the inner side, which encloses cytoplasm, yolk and the nucleus. The periplasm is another more delicate lining, prevails from the inner side to the vital membrane. Cytoplasm, it is a living substance of an egg which nourishes the embryo. Yolk or ectoplasm is a non-living substance of the egg which consists of the carbohydrates, proteins, lipids scattered as the globules throughout the reticulum of the cytoplasm. Nucleus is a highly organized dynamic part of the egg, insect egg, containing chromatin or the which forms the chromosomes. This is genetic material encoded in a giant molecules of DNA, which are genes that bear the hereditary character from one generation to the another generation. This is the structure of the egg, which is described in the earlier slide. The center is the nucleus, the yolk, cytoplasm, the vital membrane, the egg shell, and there is small opening at the left side, it is the micropyle. This is typical of the insect egg. Different forms and the pattern of the egg laying of the insect. Eggs of the different insects vary greatly in appearance, or the egg laying pattern of the or the shape of the egg is may be different from order to order. Most of eggs are spherical, oval or elongated, but some are barrel shape or some are cigarette shape or disc shape. Oviposition, that is a process of the egg deposition, is known as the oviposition. Take place in a diverse way, that eggs may be laid singly or in a group, so enclosed in a gelatinous masses, scales, or may be laid in a protective case, that is aethica or egg pod. In the case of the grasshopper and cockroaches, they are having the provisions to protect the eggs in the egg pod or aethica. In Lepidoptera, they are laid singly in groups with covering with the scales of that abdomen. The types of larvae and pupa. Types of larvae and pupa. Larvae is the immature stage of the Lepidopteran insect. That is the here the difference is shown in the immature stage of the incomplete type of metamorphosis and the complete type of metamorphosis. Incomplete type of metamorphosis, immature stage is known as the larvae, and in incomplete type of metamorphosis, the immature stage is known as the nymph. The immature, this is difference between larvae and nymph. The immature stages of the exopterygota insects are known as the nymphs, where endopterygota insects, the immature stage is known as the larvae. Difference between larvae and nymph. It is the larvae, it is the immature stage of the endopterygota, here it is the immature stage of the exopterygota. The undergoes holometamorphosis, here nymph undergoes the hemimetamorphosis. Body is vermiform, which differ from adult both in structure and feeding habits. Here, body is resembles the adult in the all characters except wings. Larvae consist of ocelli and reduced to antenna, but in the case of nymph, having the compound as an antenna, pair of antenna. Larvae possess both thoracic and abdominal legs, but where in the case of nymph, only it possesses thoracic legs. The larvae have a different larvae is different from the adult in the feeding habits and behavior, where nymph resembles the adult in the feeding habits and the behavior. The larva enters the pupal stage, and the nymph having no pupal stage, only three stages of life cycle. For example, in larvae, Lepidoptera and Coleoptera, where in nymph, the examples from the order Hemiptera and Arthroptera. This is the basic difference between larvae and nymph. This may be asked in your examination, so you have to must remember all these differential facts. The types of larvae, first is the protobird larvae, second one is the oligobird larvae, where it has again the their subtypes, compotiform larvae and scabidiform larvae. Polypod larvae, which having the iriciform larvae, having hairy spongy caterpillar, and looper and seam looper. Apodous larvae, eucephalus, hemicephalus, acephalus. Apodous larvae is larvae having no types of the development in the eggs. First is the protopod larvae, that is endoparasitic Hymenoptera. The larvae are partially developed. They possess well-developed head and thoracic segments but lack segmentation in the abdomen. They possess a rudimentary cephalic and thoracic appendages but no abdominal appendages. They have partially developed digestive system and underdeveloped respiratory and nervous systems. Oligobird larvae. These are characterized by the presence of the well-developed thoracic legs, head capsule and without any abdominal legs. These are classified into two types, namely compotiform and scabidiform larvae. This is the endoparasitic protopod example of the protopod larvae. Here it is from the Hymenoptera. Then difference between compotiform larvae and scabidiform larvae. The body is divided. A body is long and fusiform shape in the compotiform larvae. In scabidiform, body is C-shaped. Typically, C-shaped larvae you can find in the vertebrate. So, body is dorsoventrally compressed with a sclerotized cuticle in case of compotiform, but in the case of the scabidiform, the body is cylindrical and subcylindrical, stout and fleshy in nature. The head type or type of the head or the head position is prognathous in compotiform, but in the case of the scabidiform, it is a hypognathous type of head position. Compotiform larvae having long thoracic legs and scabidiform having a short thoracic leg. A pair of terminal abdominal processes, that is anal sulci, is present in the compotiform, whether it is absent in scabidiform larvae. This is very active compotiform larvae, but scabidiform larvae is very inactive. It is the predator in nature compotiform larvae, and the scabidiform is the phytophagus that is damaging to the insect, damaging to the plant surface. The example is Neuroptera trichoptera that feeds on the its prey, act as a natural enemy, where the scabidi from the Coleoptera like white grub is feeding on the root system of the plant. So this is the basic difference between compotiform larvae and scabidiform larvae. This is the example of the compotiform larvae. This is the larvae of ladybug beetle feeds on the aphids. This is the scabidiform larvae is feeds on the roots of the sugarcane, groundnut, etc. This is a compotiform larvae, that is from Neuroptera, feeds on the aphids. This is a larvae of ladybug beetle. This is scabidiform larvae of the white grub, which lives underside the under the soil. Then polypod larvae or iriciform larvae. The larvae possess a well developed segmentation of the body with three pairs of thoracic legs, two to five pairs of the abdominal legs. It present on 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, and 10th abdominal segment. They are phytophagous and destructive type of pest having great damage to the crop. Different type of the polypod larvae. First, the hairy caterpillar. That larval body is fully covered with the small hairs. For example, red hairy caterpillar or castor hairy caterpillar. Or, the hairy caterpillar is which observed very easily in the field. Then second one, the spongy caterpillar. Spongy caterpillar, that larvae consist of a horn-like structure or hook-like structure at the dorsal surface of the 8th abdominal segment. That is, for example, gingival dead head moth. The looper type of larvae, only two pairs of abdominal legs present on 6th and last abdominal segment. During walking, in the insect body forms a complete loop-like structure, hence the name is looper. For example, is mango looper. The semilooper, the castor semilooper, that first two pairs of the abdominal set legs on 3rd and 4th segments are reduced. Hence, a part of the insect body forms a small loop during its movement. For example, is castor semilooper. This is the example of this hairy caterpillar having small hairs all over the body. This is spindly caterpillar having the hook-like structure at the distal end, abdomen ends. This is the looper, mango looper, having forming the loop. Only the abdominal segment having the leg and thoracic segment. This is a castor semi looper having abdominal legs also at the distal end also and even in middle also and having the true thoracic legs. So this is the example of the larvae. The apodous larvae, these are characterized with the absence of the trunk appendages or legs. They possess three pairs of sensory papillae in the place of the thoracic legs for the locomotion. They are usually derived from the oligopod type based on the degree of development of the head capsule and its appendages. These larvae are divided into three different subtypes. First is the Eucephalus, for example, suborder Nematocera of Diptera, Mosquito, Pulchidae family. The larvae consist of a well-sclerotized head capsule. Hemicephalus, that is from Bachycera of Diptera, robber flies Aslidae. Larvae possess a partially developed head capsule. Acephalus, for example, Cycloryphe of Diptera, Musidae family, that is a family of housefly. The larvae are characterized with the absence of the head capsule and mouth parts are represented by only the mouth hooks. So this is all the subparts of the larvae having no legs or having the limited development in the legs. This type of characteristic is found in the Diptera, mostly Diptera, and even the Mosquito also having the same type of the larval type. So this is the example of this mosquito larvae having some little development. This is the rubber fly larvae having only the small hook like structure. This is the house fly larvae also having this small black color hook, which is as a mouth part. So this is types from the apodous larvae. So we will move towards the type of pupa. It is a resting and inactive stage of the holometabolous insect, or those insects having the complete type of metamorphosis having only this type of modifications, and the transition phase during the in which wings are developed in the insect and insect attain mature sexual organs. The pupa is incapable of the feeding locomotion, except in some cases where they are prowl. Neuroptera aphid lion, that is a mosquito. Later it emerge as adult. The pupation may take place either in soil or either on the plant surface or within the waves or within the stem in the damaging plant part. So this is the modification, which is one type of the rest stage. So pupa is divided into the following bases based on the presence and absence of the powerful mandibles. They are classified into dectitious pupa and adactitious pupa. Dectitious pupa possesses relatively powerful mandibles which are used to escape of the adults from the cocoons. It is helped to break the cocoon, hard cocoon. For example, in Neuroptera, the strong mandibles are helpful to break the cocoon to get emerge the adult. In the case of the adactitious pupa, do not possess the mandibles, but with the help of the other appendages, adult can escape from the cocoon. For example, Lepidoptera and Diptera having such type of the modifications. Second classification is based on the attachment of the appendages or shape of the pupa. First is the exarete pupa, for example is Coleoptera. The pupa having appendages which are free without any secondary attachment to the body, and the apteric pupa, it is from specially the Lepidoptera or moths family. So pupa having appendages which are firmly pressed against the body, and the pupa is highly chitinized. Chitinized structure is covered the body and it is firmly pressed. So even we can imagine the mouth parts, legs, and from the inside in outside of the pupa. In case of the exarete pupa, the appendages are free without any attachment to the body. This is the third one, is the coracoid type of pupa, whether it is enclosed puparium having the capsule like structure or barrel like structure, which having very barrel like shape of this pupa is found in the housefly, Diptera housefly. Chrysalis, it is a uptake type of pupa which has in golden coloration, silver coloration, very attractive in a shape, which attached to the stalk of the plant, with stalk to the plant. For example, popularly found in the all types of the butterflies. This is uptake type of pupa. This is corrected type of pupa. This is chrysalis. This is other type of pupa. This is a diagrammatic presentation. Then here, this is the actual photographs showing the different character. This is the exact type of pupa, whether all the body segments are freely attached to each other. This is the optic type pupa having the pupa rim cover and all the body appendages is firmly pressed in the one unit structure. This is the corrected type of pupa having the barrel shell. This is a golden silver colored attractive color pupa type. It is a chrysalis. So this is all about the types of pupa. This presentation includes the types of eggs, type of larvae, type of pupa. This will help for your getting clear the concept of the after the metamorphosis, the type of eggs and their the type of larvae and type of pupa. This video is prepared specially for the undergraduate students for educational purpose. This video is not for the commercial purpose. So thanking you for your kind attention.